Hi everyone, Giuliano here. In this video, I'll show you how you can protect org data across your mobile devices. I'll show you how you can encrypt, how you can handle copy and paste across managed and unmanaged apps, and more. I will show you how you can use Microsoft Intune to rule all these things. Alright, let's get started. Here I am on my Android device. I'm recording my Android device because for my protection policy, I can record my screen and I can even take a screenshot. I will show you in a bit. So first of all, what I'm going to do is open Microsoft Teams, and here I have a chat. So I can open this chat with my colleague and then I can try to copy this link. Okay, I'm copying something from a content in Teams, and then I'm trying to use another app, which is in this case Google Translate. So Google Translate is a managed app for me and for Intune. That means that when I try to paste the content here, what I will have is a message that tells me that this is not possible. So your organization data cannot be pasted here. Because Google Translate, it's an unmanaged app for Intune, and I can do that. So another thing that I would like to do right now is taking a screenshot. So let me try to... So as you can see, I can take a screenshot of my screen, but when I open an app, a Microsoft 365 app of my organization, and when I try to take a screenshot, so what I have here, it's a message, can take screenshots. And in the same way, I can't record any app that I have on my organization. Let's try to record this screen. So now, theoretically, I'm recording. As you can see here, I have 5 seconds, 6 seconds. Now let me stop this and let me open the folder where this record is stored. So it is this one. So let me play this, and it is a blank, totally black screen. I recorded also previously another video. I opened it in this case Microsoft Teams. I was in the screen that was clear, that was available, but when I tried to open a Microsoft 365 app or via or my organization, that was not able because of my app protection policy. So this is how you can handle this kind of thing. So another thing that I would like to show you is how works the sharing functionality with across apps. So let's say that you have in your inbox, let me go here now on the inbox of my organization. So let's say that I want to copy something here. I received this email, so I want to copy this content. And I can do the same as we have seen before. Or I can try to share an attachment that I have, that I received. So let me filter here the email as attachments. I can open this one, for example. So let me open this image. And now when I try to share this, what I have here as possibilities are only managed apps, only trusted apps that are in Intune. So these are my managed apps, which are part of Microsoft 365. I can share this content in Outlook only outside and across managed apps. That's how it works. I copied previously a text. I can reopen here Google Translate. Then let me keep pressed here, and then I can try to paste what I copied before, and I have the same message. I can copy text from managed app, but I can paste it in unmanaged apps. So this is how you can have app protection policy running and working on your organization. Here I am in intune.microsoft.com of my Microsoft 365 tenant. So I have my device, my Android device, enrolled in Intune. So clicking on Android, I can see all devices that I have currently, and mine is this one. So let's now go back, and the section that I would like to highlight here is the App Protection Policy. So we are going to talk about this. So if we want to configure Intune to have the experience more or less that we have seen before in the demo, I'll show you how you can achieve this goal. So let's click on Apps, and then all we have to do is click on App Protection Policies. Here, what I have are two policies. It's a good practice to have a test policy with a few people in a group, so you can test what you are going to roll out globally before to do it. So it's a very good approach. So what I have, let's go with that one, is this apps test protection policy. I am the only one that is checked in with this policy for the moment, but this is not very important. Now, clicking on properties, we have several sections here. Let's go one by one. When you create the first time a new policy, you are going to enter all these data in one by one. So we have basics, apps, data protection. These are the main pillars of this policy: access requirements, conditional launch, and so on. All right, let's start from the beginning. And what you have to insert at the beginning is, of course, the name and the description. And then you have to select the platform. I have an Android device enrolled for my organization. Then I selected Android. But there is, of course, iOS as well. Okay, let's click on Cancel now. And let's go with the second section, which is, in this case, Apps. This is absolutely important. You have to decide which apps you want to target. The target policy in this drop-down can be all apps, all Microsoft apps, or core apps. So I selected all these apps. So this is my apps catalog, which are managed for my organization. It means these are officially released for my organization and recognized as trusted app for my mobile devices. So this is the list that I added, and down below I have also custom apps. This is added out of the box. I have com.microsoft.rdc.android. You can add additional custom apps if you want. How I can add additional apps is just a matter of clicking on this link, select public apps, and on the right side you will see a panel showing up, and here then you can select all apps that you want. You can search for specific app. It's very up to you. There are plenty. There is WebEx, for example, Zoom, you can add this as well, Slack, and so on. Okay. Let's click now on Cancel. Let's move on with the other section, which is, in this case, Data Protection. This is also super important. So let's go one by one. What you have here is the ability to backup org data to Android backup services. I set this for my use case to block. Then you can send org data to other apps. This is crucial. So you have to decide how to go forward with that. I selected that I can send org data only across managed apps, so the list of apps that we have seen before. Then you can select also apps to exempt if you want. Save copies of org data. This is also absolutely important. This means that user can store on the device org data, and I set block this. Another important thing is to define the source where users can save org data. And in my case, I selected OneDrive for Business and SharePoint. Local storage is not selected, so that means that if I have Outlook attachments, I can save it, or if I start to create a PowerPoint on my mobile device, I can store it and save it only on SharePoint and OneDrive for Business. Then, let's move forward with other important topics. We have transferred telecommunication data to any dialer app. Here, you can restrict this behavior as well. This is the part related to dialer and telecommunication. I will skip this, but it's pretty intuitive. Then, let's go with open data into org documents. I set this to block and allow user to open data from selected services. So I can open data from OneDrive for Business, SharePoint, my camera, my photo gallery. This is also important because if you want to share, if you want to take a photo and then share it directly in Teams, then it's important to have this checkbox selected. Another super important capability is this one, restrict cat copy and paste between other apps. This is what we have seen before, copying content from Teams on Outlook, just copying text and paste it in an unmanaged app like Google Translate. As we have seen in the demo, this is not allowed. And that's the reason why I selected this option, policy managed apps with paste in. It means that I can copy and paste the content from Teams to Outlook, from Outlook to Microsoft Loop, and so on. All apps contained in the catalog that we have seen before, in the list that we have seen before. Then there is screen capture and Google Assistant. So I tried to take a screenshot and this was blank, taking a screenshot of a managed app that was Teams for my demo. Then approved keyboards and finally encryption. So I set this to require, so I want to encrypt org data on enrolled device. My device is enrolled. It means that all my org data are encrypted there and I have more security. Functionality. You can sync policy managed apps with native apps or add-in. I set this to block. Then printing org data, I set this block as well. Restrict the web content transfer with other apps. What I selected here is Microsoft Edge. This is the official browser. It means that if I have a link in Teams, in a Teams chat or in Outlook, when I tap on the link, the browser that will open, it will be Microsoft Edge and only Microsoft Edge. Then org data notification, I set to allow. You can also block this as well if you want. Start Microsoft Tunnel connection on app launch. This is also a selection that you can set, yes or no. All right, this was the core, I would say, of the policy. This is the data protection of the policy. Let's click on cancel now. We have seen this. And let's move with access requirements. This is also very important. It is how users access to the org apps. So you can set a PIN if you want. I set not required, but if you want, you can set required and you can decide if numeric or passcode, a simple PIN, the number of digits that you want to have, the minimum PIN length, biometrics instead of PIN for access. This is also useful instead of adding always the PIN, timeout, minutes of inactivity, 30, then biometrics. This is the Android 9 version is required. This change, of course, if you have an iOS device. PIN reset after number of days. You can set the number of days when a user needs to change the PIN. And then finally, we have even the ability to say app PIN when device PIN is set, require or not. And then if you want to have credential, that the user add credential to access to the app. I set this to not required. Recheck the access requirements after minutes of inactivity. I set 30. This is very, depends from the organization, of course. I set now cancel because I want to show you another important feature, which is the section conditional launch. And here you can set offline grace period, block access after a number of, I set this one, this number, if the user is no longer online, you can give an offline grace period, otherwise the device is blocked. Offline grace period is 90, and then after 90 days the data are wiped out. It's not allowed to access with jailbroken rooted devices. The access is blocked. You can add additional option here. You can require a minimum OS version, otherwise you don't allow user to access to Microsoft 365 apps or to your managed apps. And then you can add additional conditions if you want. Let's click on cancel. And let's wrap up these settings now with the assignments. So what I defined here is a group. This is the Intune pilot group. So you can add a group which is involved and targeted by this policy. You can add and exclude groups if you want. You can also edit. So if you have a large group, you can narrow the users of this group by adding filters. So you can specify only a specific device or only specific user of a department and so on. So you can narrow and filter the group. That's it. So this is how you can create and handle apps and protect data in your mobile devices in your organization. I hope you enjoyed this video. If yes, please consider to subscribe, like, add a comment down below. Let me know what do you think. I hope to see you next time. Bye.